Tonight, we continue our journey on the Oklahoma Honor Flight. I was invited to go along with 100 veterans from World War II to visit their memorial. It was an amazing journey. I met veterans who have had a long life. You know, many of them are now in their 90s, as well as the volunteers who make Oklahoma Honor Flights happen.
To go on the Oklahoma Honors Flight, I knew we'd see the World War II Memorial, Iwo Jima, and Air Force memorials, but I learned way more just by talking to this generation of near centurions. They are a living history, like Caesar Latimer. His son was with him on this day telling us about coming back from Okinawa.
When he got out of the service, he came back to Oklahoma.
Caesar came back and worked in the family barbecue business, but he really wanted to be a lawyer. But there was a problem back in the 1940s.
You wanted to do that, but you couldn't do that just because of the color of your skin.
That's right.
Denied the education here because he wasn't white. But he persevered and went out of state to college and got that degree and made sure he came back to Oklahoma for one reason.
Because I realized Oklahoma was mistreating blacks. And somebody got to start doing something about it. So I made up my mind. I told my discharge sergeant in the Marine Corps that I was coming back to Oklahoma and help black people.
You see, Caesar Latimer learned about helping others by helping his country, an example his son will never forget.
Like I said, he's a hero to me, and I'm sure to his country as well, and he's taught me a lot of things.
It's that teaching that leaves a legacy, says Oklahoma Honor Flight Guardian Ruth Kaiser. She's principal at Del City Elementary, and her school kids gave their own money to the Oklahoma Honor Flight so these veterans could go on this trip for free.
On Tuesday, Popcorn Day, the whole school forfeited their popcorn and gave the 50 cents to the Honors Flight.
They gave their piggy bank money, their tooth fairy money, all to help support these trips that cost $100,000 apiece. The lesson?
We talked a lot about, you know, what freedom is and that freedom is something that it's their duty to carry on also. We tried to explain to them that this way of life just didn't come free.
Ruth was thrilled to come on this flight and see for herself what it means to these veterans.
And we're losing World War II veterans at 1,000 a day. So time is of the essence, and that I think it's very important that these men and women see the honor that we want to give them, the honor that was due.
Honor to those like Caesar Latimer, who heartily approves.
And I thought they did a wonderful job.
It is a beautiful memorial, a beautiful trip to honor these men and women who gave so much. And for Ruth, the word she heard touched her the most from veterans who know freedom comes at a price.
All this time has passed, but they said I would do it again to preserve the freedom that we have.
Well, if you want a veteran to go on that flight and you want to help them out, the Honor Flight, if you are a World War II veteran as well, I've got the numbers that you need. Here they are, 259-9000. You can also go to OklahomaHonorFlights.org. And Maggie, a lot of these folks, they are 90 years old, and they say, well, how can I do this? You know, get your son or your daughter to go on that Oklahoma Honor Flight, or you can call them, and they can help out and get them on these trips.
Well, you were talking about Caesar while your story was playing, and you said he became a lawyer in Tulsa.
Yeah, he did become a lawyer in Tulsa. Just retired a couple of years ago, so it's an amazing
man.
Yeah, amazing stories.